What is the PM Kisan scheme? PM Kisan is a central sector scheme with 100% funding from the Government of India. It was launched in 2019. Under the scheme, an income support of 6,000 rupees per year in 3 equal installments will be provided to small and marginal farmer families having combined land holding or ownership of up to 2 hectares. Since June 2020, the scheme was revised to include all the farmers, irrespective of the size of their holding. There are 11.5 crore beneficiaries registered under the scheme. West Bengal is the only state that is yet to join the scheme. The state government and UT administration identify the farmer families which are eligible for support as per scheme guidelines, and funds will be directly transferred to the bank accounts of the beneficiaries. While there are various exclusion categories under the scheme, according to the information obtained under the RTI Act, PM Kisan payout of about Rs. 1,364 crores went to 20 lakh undeserving beneficiaries. A major chunk of these ineligible beneficiaries belongs to 5 states: Punjab, Assam, Maharashtra, Gujarat, and Uttar Pradesh. Punjab with 23%, Maharashtra with 17%, Assam with 14%, followed by Gujarat and Uttar Pradesh with 8% each. People who are not eligible for the scheme: if any member of a farming family paid income tax, received a monthly pension above Rs. 10,000, held a constitutional position, or was a serving or retired government employee, they were not eligible for the scheme. The Union Agriculture Ministry, in response to the RTI application, identified 2 categories of undeserving beneficiaries who received PM Kisan payouts as ineligible farmers and income tax pay farmers. However, scamsters successfully registered on the PM Kisan portal using publicly available Aadhaar numbers, a bank account number, land record details, and a phone number. This data was accepted by the official public financial management system software, thereby making them eligible to receive a direct bank transfer of Rs. 2000 per installment up to Rs. 6000 a year. Despite an increasing trend in the number of beneficiaries with every installment period, there is still a gap in coverage, with the agriculture census showing that at least 3 crore eligible farmers are yet to be reached.